What is 3ds Max CAD? If you are an animator or a rigger, beware because you will be using CAD after watching this video. No joke, because CAD is one of the best animation systems to use, even though it's older than your grandpa, but we will get to that. Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý.
What is CAD? 3ds Max CAD.
No, there won't be any more kittens in the video. Or will they? No, they won't. This is a serious video. CAD is an animation system similar to Biped or regular Max Bones or Human IK and so on. It's a set of tools that help you rig and animate. It started out as a plugin for 3ds Max and was later bought out by Autodesk and built into 3ds Max. And abandoned, like you know some other stuff they bought? Something. It was built into 3ds Max in version 2010 and got only a few updates since then. But let's not focus on that, because you know that one software you use and don't want to upgrade to newer version because it's just working fine for what you need. And you still use version from 2008. Well, this is not it because you would want CAD to get an update, but you know what I mean. CAD still does its job well though. I personally use CAD for over 8 years now and I know companies that have full animation workflows built around CAD. I will show you some features that you can only dream of in other animation systems. Okay, well, this is 3ds Max. Pretty cool, right? You have never seen that before. But this is where you find CAD, just for your information. Create panel, helpers, CAD parent. And you will get this beautiful triangle. But this is not a tutorial, no. Don't worry, you will not be learning anything today. I will be just showing you things. And wanted to show where the CAD is because everybody has it in 3ds Max, but only like 12 people know about it. By the way, this video is a remake of my very first video, which got quite popular over its time, so I decided it deserves a remake. Because everything deserves a remake. Disney needs to start doing remakes of remakes pretty soon because otherwise they are lost. Bought by Epic Games or something. But let's get to those features of CAD because this is getting boring already. Take a look at this. It's extremely fast to build a rig from scratch in CAD. I will show you. You remember our beautiful triangle, right? Now select it. Click on Create Pelvis. Add some legs. Let's make it with 3 bones. Now adding another leg will create a copy of the first one. Let's continue with spine. Well, actually no, let's move it to the side here and create another spine. Now copy the first one and mirror it. Now some arms. Add some fingers. Maybe even twist bones. Copy the arm to the other side. Let's actually add one finger bone to the feet as well. You can see creating all of these things is just few clicks and setting of parameters. Now another spine for the head. The double head actually. And okay, this is getting pretty messed up. Well, actually no, it's still not messed up enough. Let's add another spine here. Make it horizontal. Okay, now we are getting somewhere. I know what you think, but no, let's add legs here. And another head to the front. Okay, well, let's not continue anymore, I guess. It looks like a rider on a horse or something, but also the rider is also the horse. Well, okay, let's move on. The point is, you can do pretty cool rigs with this, and also really fast compared to other animation systems. We all know rigging takes quite some time, but with CAD it will take you half that. Try it out. Okay, let's talk about something else. You know when you are doing a big project where you have a ton of characters and you need to share some animations between them. CAD has got you even here. Take a look at this robot. He's running, right? Very nice. Now I want to transfer it to another character. So I will save the animation. Now this Charmander here. Let's load it on it. Now we have to enable the animation mode to see it. It looks broken, but move the timeline to update. It needs a lot of adjusting, but it's the same animation and works perfectly fine even when it's completely different character with different rig and amount of bones. For example, the tail doesn't move here because of this, of course. But it works. Yes, game engines can do retargeting as well, but imagine that you don't want the animation to be exactly the same here on this character as it was on the robot. You can use this just as a base and make a completely different animation. This would save you some work of animating from scratch. But that's nothing, let's load it here on this pigeon, a completely different rig. Well, it's much more messed up and a stupid example, but it works. Let me disable the wings for this layer so we can see it better. Pretty funny. Well, okay, this is stupid. But you can see it works! I just love it. By the way, you can download all the 3D models you saw here on my website for free. No catches or ads in your face, nothing. I give them out for free for everybody. And I even feel like since starting this channel, even the community around CAD is growing. Look, I've got 3 million subscribers here. Even on my Discord server, it's like 2 million people where we help each other. And even you can be a part of that by subscribing to the channel, because all I talk about here is 3DS Max CAD. Like really, if you would take me out on a beer, this would be the only thing I would talk about. Well, okay, I do watch a lot of movies and TV shows and play games, so maybe a bit about that as well. We would for sure end up as best friends since then. But okay, I got sidetracked again. Look at this now. Maybe you were wondering what was that magic with disabling the wings for the pigeon I showed you. Well, it's the animation layer system. Most of other animation systems have one, so it's not that super exclusive to CAD, but it's still something worth mentioning. CAD has a pretty thought out layer system. In this example, I have a simple animation in several layers. One absolute one, and the rest all additive to that one, which add up to the final animation. If I disable all the additive layers, there will be no animation left, because in the absolute layer I have only the static pose. Then, if I turn on the breathing layer, it adds up my animated breathing to that pose. Another layer is some head movements on top of that. Then some eye blinking. Ears, eyes movement. They all add up to the final animation. The advantage of animating like this is that you have more control of the keys and curves between them. Instead of one giant mess, you can separate them to layers. Also, you could now copy just the breathing layer, for example, and load it on a different character to share just this single layer and animate the rest. In the pigeon example I have shown you before, I have 2 absolute layers now, but the wings have 0 weights in the yellow run layer. You can see the 0 when I select the wing. Also, if I enable coloring mode, you can see more clearly which layer affects which bones, as they are color-coded. Pretty awesome. And remember that subscribing I talked about. I also have a Patreon where I love all the people that support me. Even those cheap ones that give only $1. No, but seriously, it's an extreme help. I live in a country where an average monthly salary is $1,000 after taxes. Minimal is $500. So I am very grateful for every single one of you. Even the $1 ones, truly. Thank you all. But okay, let's get to the last thing. And this one is the biggest. After all you have seen so far, this is even better. I told you that you will want to use CAD after watching this video. The thing I'm talking about is procedural animation. Let's get back to the first run we had at the beginning. This run was animated without keying a single keyframe, and that is by a motion layer, which is another type of animation layer in 3ds Max CAD, represented by this figure icon here. For a motion layer, you can open up this window here, which contains all the parameters for every bone in the rig. By changing these parameters, you can change the look of the animation, and that is how you achieve the final result. You can also make the character move in space instead of on place, with just one click. Or even move on a custom created spline. You can change speeds with just editing the parameters and so much more. However, bear in mind that it also takes some getting used to. It's a different style of animation, but absolutely incredible for creating cycled animations. But when you first create a motion layer, the animation looks something like this. So yeah, it needs some editing to say the least. And also, this is something that almost none other software or animation system has, not even Maya or Motion Builder. And it's incredibly powerful. Okay, so what do you think? Did 3ds Max CAD get you interested? If you watched it this far, I guess it did. If so, or if you already are a CAD user, please do something for the community and do this one thing. Head to the Autodesk official site and get to the 3ds Max ideas. I will also put the link below the video. Sorted by top voted, and not far below, currently it's on a second page, there is a suggestion for Autodesk to update CAD. Vote for it and let's try to move it as high as possible so Autodesk could maybe notice it and do something about it. It's the official way how the community can help to advance the 3ds Max software. This specific post here is from 2017, so I know it's probably a fool's hope. But a lot of things from this list have already been implemented into 3ds Max since then. So maybe we will get lucky. It's the least we can do. Okay, so that's it. And if you know anyone who might be interested in CAD, this is the video to share with them. Okay, well, that's it from me for today. See you in another video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.